Anna was training to be a veterinarian when the war broke out. The Germans were only 20 miles from Paris when she received a letter from her father. He was in good health, but implored her not to return home to Belgium until the war's end. Patience, however, was not one of Anna's strong suits.
Thank you.
September 7th, 1914. Taxis drove all night. Anna was proud to help the soldiers reach the front line. When Anna arrived at her destination, she discovered the horrible truth with her own eyes.
No. Allez, lâche-toi. Non.
Seven months went by. Driven by compassion, Anna devoted herself, body and soul, to healing the wounded and the sick. Every life saved was another small victory over the war. The conflict, however, raged on.
Bravo, vous le dégelez.
Oh, bon vieux.
bord. Hey, violon, raconte-nous. Regasse. On coupe la connue. Hey, Martin, mets l'attaqueur sur moi. Elle tombe la grillard pour la connue.
Hey, hey. Non.
The French officers were talking about Belgium. The German army was about to experiment with a new weapon near Ypres, Anna's hometown.
Papa!
Anna got en route to warn her father about the imminent danger. Reaching the outskirts of the city, Anna was greeted by the screams of sirens. The deadly gas was already here.
No. Oh,
The governess revealed to her that her father, an eminent scientist, had been kidnapped by Baron von Dorf, who was eager to use scientific advances in warfare. Anna set out in pursuit of the Baron and encountered Emil and Freddy. Destiny brought them together. They had survived the enemy's wrath, their gunfire, bombardments, gas attacks.
No! No!
Now, with her father within reach, Anna wasn't going to let him slip away.
Helga,
Sacrebleu!
Thank you. Get away, boy. Vas-y. Hey, Walt, shoot, Walt.
Walt.
Shut up.
Hey, hey.
Allez, Walt. Get away, boy.
Merci, mon ami.
Vas-y.
Allez, allez.
Victory had a bittersweet taste for Anna. Carl, seriously wounded, had been sent to a POW camp. Anna's father had disappeared with Baron von Dorf, and Emil was court-martialed for desertion. Cited for his bravery in Reims, Emil was fortunately pardoned and set free. Free to go back to the front. February 21st, 1916. Winter had descended on the front. After joining back up with the army, Emil and Freddy were stationed near Verdun, suffering like many others from the harsh winter. That morning, the arrival of the mail raised spirits, but Marie's letter did not bring good news. In Saint-Mihiel, food was scarce, disease was rife, and the number of dead was growing. Out of this grim news, however, there was one ray of light, a photo of his grandson, Victor, standing on both feet and learning to walk.
Don't worry, friend.
Hey, what?
Des fumants.
Pas de pilier.
Buffalo.
Pas de brignole pour toi, le bigonneau.
My dearest daughter, I heard from Carl. His condition is stable. He is still in the prisoner camp south of Reims. I hope to finally get permission to visit him. Thank you for the photo. It means so much.
On bouge pas.
Allez, vamos, vamos, vamos.
Enemy down!
Oh,
Precision cannon firing enabled Freddy and his regiment to reach the rear line unharmed.
Bravo, Freddy!
Bill, thank you very much.
The military hierarchy heard of their feats in battle and decided to decorate the two friends for their bravery. Emil received good news from Anna. Carl was recovering nicely. He was even walking again. Meanwhile, the battle for Verdun only grew longer and bloodier. The death toll was staggering, 70,000 per month. Almost one Frenchman and one German every minute, and it went on for 10 months, day and night. May 8th, 1916, Emile's squad was sent on a mission to take back Fort Douaumont, a strategic point in the German defense.
Yes, sir. Come on.
Yeah.
Shut up! go. Get out.
Thank you.
Despite the fort's partial destruction, the Germans held their position. The mission was a failure.